वेलकम टू ऑरियंत इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सोलापुर फॉर ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन 2020-21. माई सेल्फ मिसेस लता कोडम. आई एम द टीचर ऑफ ईवीएस सब्जेक्ट.
स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेसन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट वेरियस सेंस ऑफ महाराष्ट्र एंड देयर टीचिंग्स. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ ब्रेव मराठा सरदार्स. Today we are going to study about Maratha Sardars of Maharashtra who are working and in the kingdom of Adil Shah and Nizam Shah. Among all the Sardars, the Bhosles of Velar was very brave. Period of unrest. As the saints preached devotion to God, the brave Maratha Sardars started a tradition of bravery. This was the period of great unrest. The two sultans, the Adil Shah of Vijapur and the Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar, were constantly at the war with each other. They made use of armies of Maratha Sardars in these wars. The brave Maratha Sardars. The Marathas were both brave and tough. Brave means ready to face any danger. They were also fearless and loyal to their masters. They were very proud of their achievements on the battlefield. The brave Maratha soldiers with the spear in hand and a sword at the side would ride in his Sardar's cavalry. All the Maratha Sardars had their own private armies. If a such Sardar went to the Sultan with his army, the Sultan gave him employment, made him a Sardar of his kingdom. And sometimes conferred a Jagir upon him. The Sardar who received such a Jagir considered himself a Raja. There were many famous Maratha Sardars at the courts of Ahmednagar and Vijapur. The more famous among them were the Jadhavs of Sindhkhed, Nimbalkars of Palthan, Gorphades of Modhul, Mores of Javli, Bhosles of Verul. The Sindhkhed Jadhavs were descendants of the Yadavs of Devgiri. Of Jadhav of Sindhkhed. Tradition of valor. All these Sardars were brave, but many of them were sworn enemies of the one another. They never thought that they should unite and do something for their own people. So all their valors and bravery served the interest of others. Even so, they kept alive the warlike spirit, especially among the young. Many famous soldiers were born in their families who kept alive the tradition of valor. Among the famous families, the Bhosles of Verul showed great bravery and enterprise. Temple of Grishneshwar. It was about 400 years ago. The temple of Grishneshwar near the Verul caves was falling to pieces. The walls had developed cracks. The priest also had deserted the temple. Thus, the temple which was built in honor of great God was totally neglected. All the devotees who came there mourned over the sorry state of temple, but no one thought of repairing it. And bail on the lingam and express his innermost thoughts to the God. He carried out extensive repair to the temple and restored it to its original condition. He also made arrangements for the proper maintenance of the temple. Now there were lights both the inside and outside the temple. And the lost grandeur of Grishneshwar was restored. Who was this devotee who did all this? He was Malloji Raje Bhosle. Bhosles of Verul. Malloji Raje Bhosle, the Patil of Verul, was a great devotee of Shiva. Babaji Raje had two sons. Malloji Raje was a elder and Vithoji Raje the younger. Babaji Raje Bhosle had the rights of a patil in the Verul village. Malloji Raje and Vithoji Raje were both brave and enterprising. They had in their service many armed Maratha troops. It was a period of great unrest. The Mughal emperor from Delhi had attacked the kingdom of Nizam Shah. Daulatabad was then the capital of Nizam Shah. Malik Ambar was his wazir of chief minister. Malik Ambar was able to wise. The two capable and brave brothers from Verul son caught his attention. On his recommendation, the Shah conferred from Malloji Raje the Jagir of Pune and Supe Paragons. So the Bhosles became rich and powerful. Malloji Raje's wife was Umabai. She came from the house of the Nimbalkars of Palthan. They had two sons, Shahaji and Sharifji. Malloji Raje killed in the battle at Indapur. At that time, Shahaji was only 5 years old. Then Vithoji Raje looked after the children and the Jagir. Later, he asked in marriage for Shahaji, the daughter of Lakoji Rao Jadhav. Jizabai, the daughter of Lakoji Rao, was well favored by the gods. Lakoji Rao accepted Vithoji Raje's proposal. Lakoji Rao was a brave and valiant sardar in the court of Nizam Shah. He kept a large army of his own. He commanded great respect and honor at the court of Nizam Shah. He celebrated the wedding of Shahaji Raje and Jizabai with a great pomp. Jizabai became the fortune of the Bhosles family. Shahaji Raje. Nizam Shah transferred to Shahaji Raje the Jagir he had conferred on Malloji Raje. Shahaji Raje was a brave and capable man held in the great respect at the court of Nizam Shah. The Mughal emperor decided to conquer the kingdom of Nizam Shah. For his, he made an alliance with the Adil Shah of Bijapur. Malik Ambar and Shahaji Raje fought bravely to save Nizam Shah. They defeated both the armies. This battle took place at Batawadi near Ahmednagar. Sharif ji was killed in the battle. Shahaji Raje displayed a great valor. He was praised everywhere as a brave general. His reputation in this court was so entrenched that even Malik Amber began to feel jealous of him. This gradually led to antagonism between them. As a result, Shahaji Raje left Nizam Shahi and joined the court of Adil Shah at Bijapur. Adil Shah honored him with the title of Sir Lashkar. Sir Lashkar means chief of army. Later, there were many developments in Nizam Shahi. The Wazir Malik Amber died. His scheming son Fateh Khan became the Wazir of Nizam Shah. During his period, the Nizam Shahi began to decline at about the same time. There was a threat for Mughal aggression. So, Nizam Shah's mother applied to Shihaji Raje to return to Nizam Shahi and save it. Therefore, Shahaji Raje left Adil Shahi and returned to Nizam Shahi. So, students, everybody understood about some Marathas in the Maharashtras? Okay, we'll meet in the next period again.